What's up, everybody? This is Anthony from Texas Blues Alley. I know that I've kind of been MIA from YouTube, at least, since Christmas, and that's because I kind of needed a break. I had some stuff around the barn I wanted to get done, so I put in some new acoustic panels, upgraded all my wiring to Cat 8, and installed a higher speed link between my house and the barn. But what snapped me out of kind of my tinkering around the barn state was I got in touch with the Vidami people, and I had anticipated a very complicated integration. It turned out to be very simple. They have done a great job and made some very wise decisions in terms of how they integrate the pedal, and that has allowed me to kind of go nuts and do some very cool stuff integrating it with my platform. So the real news here is that I'm about to release version 7.6 of the TXBA Pro Player, which is the custom player that my members use when they join the TXBA Locals. And I'm going to show you some of the new features. The big one, of course, is integration with the Vidami pedal. And I'm going to show that last because it's so cool. But there's just a few other little features I want to show you. So, take that off screen here. The first feature that most people will care about is that now when you have a loop activated, instead of staying in the little tiny loop area down here, it fills up the whole timeline. So you can now more easily track where you are in the loop. Another thing, pitch shift used to be a feature that was almost impossible to do because very few browsers supported the underlying technology, but a lot of things have changed. So I've had the ability to do half step up pitch shifting so that people could take my courses in E flat and play them in standard. I am happy to say that now pitch shift works in every browser that I've tested on every device, and you can go nuts. I'm not sure why you'd want to take a course that's in A and play it in E, but you can do that. It also means that my Jimi Hendrix course that's in D, I think that's Voodoo Child Blues, you can bump that up two semitones to E, standard tuning. So that's going to be incredibly useful for people who have had to switch guitars. And this, again, this will work in, I've tested it on Chrome and Safari on Mac, and Firefox, Firefox, I don't think it worked at all before. Definitely not on Safari, but it does now. I've tested it on Edge and Chrome and Firefox on Windows. I've tested it in Firefox, Chrome, and Safari on iOS. And I've tested it on an old Android tablet in Chrome, and it all just works. So kudos to the people who have been working on those browsers behind the scene, because that has made it work flawlessly. So that's big news. And another thing I've added is that now when you have a course, you do this info drop down, it tells you what the tuning is used in the course. So there you can calculate what you want your offset to be. One last little feature before we get to the Vidami stuff. I've had several people complain about printing tablature from inside the Sound Slice player, and they do a pretty good job with it. The only problem is that when you have a really dense bar of notes, it's very hard for them to format it correctly. So what I've done is I've gathered all my tabs, and now anytime you're on a tablature segment in the Pro Player, you'll very easily be able to download a nicely printed PDF version of it to print. So that is all the small changes for version 7.6. Now let's talk about the big thing, which is the Vidami integration. So if you don't know about the Vidami pedal, they came out, I think it was about 2 years ago, maybe three, and basically they give the ability to do speed and looping, play, pause, rewind, and fast forward on YouTube and I think Vimeo. And when I got in contact with them, I thought that this was going to be difficult because I have my own player. And it turns out they did it absolutely smart way, which made it pretty much frictionless for me to do this. The only caveat is that if you are using the Vidami pedal with Chrome or something and you have their extension installed, you're going to need to disable that to use it with a Pro Player because I'm handling all of the commands directly in my own code. But once you've done that, here is how it works. So in regular mode, that is where Regular mode is when there is no loop defined. Pretty simple. Play pause button does exactly what you would think. Play pause. Speed button drops the speed by 15% with each tap. You can see that down here. Down to 25%. And then to reset it, you just hold the speed button. It goes back up to 100%. You can see here, it synchronizes with my own speed slider in here. Okay. Back button. Jump back 5 seconds. Hold back. Jump back to the beginning. Forward. 5 seconds at a time. Hold it. Jumps 10 seconds. Now, basic looping is using when you're using the Vidami pedal to set the loop in and out points, similar to how you would do it with the A and B buttons here. So let's say you want to learn that lick right there. Tap once to set the in point. Tap again to set the out point. And so these buttons light up to show you that the in and the out of the loop are set. Once that loop is defined, this loop button will now toggle looping mode on and off. And when looping mode is on, it jumps into looping mode. You can see the loop shown here. Tapping the loop button again will simply turn looping mode on and off. It will not clear your loop. If you want to clear your loop, you just hold the button down, now it clears the in and the out point. So you can... And when you have the loop turned on, you can slow it down with the speed button. Okay? Pretty simple. That's, as far as I know, that's how it works with pretty much every other site. So here's where it gets special. One of the features of my Pro Player that I'm particularly proud of is that I have all these instant loops programmed where with just a single click, it goes to exact. Like when I teach a solo, I break it into individual licks and they each have a name. And these loops for a given lesson correspond to the same licks as I call them in the lesson. So one click and it automatically sets the perfect loop. So, I did not want using the Vidami pedal to interfere with that. I wanted it to enhance it. So here's where it's different. When you have activated an instant loop here, hitting the loop button will simply toggle looping on and off. It's not going to set an in point, not going to set an out point. You've already done that by activating the instant loop. The other thing that's different is that you can use the back and forward buttons to navigate through this list. So if I hold the back button, it goes to the next previous instant loop on the list. And so with this pedal now, you can navigate through the predefined loops for whatever video you're looking at. Now, when a loop is defined, whether it's instant looping mode or regular, tapping the back button once will simply restart the loop. Instead of rewinding 5 seconds, it'll just automatically restart the loop. And while you're in a loop, forward will only go forward 1 second because it's usually a shorter amount of time. It doesn't make as much sense to go forward 5 seconds. And if you're ready to kind of clear everything, you just hold the play pause button down and that clears your loop. Clears your instant loop if you had one selected, and it resets your speed back to 100. So, I am super pumped about how much this integration is going to potentially affect members of the locals who use this. Because back when I was learning guitar, I was kind of past albums. In terms of vinyl, we were past CDs kind of, or past tape, and we were on to CDs. And so my entire method of learning stuff from Stevie Ray Vaughan was using the back button on a CD player to kind of do this very primitive looping. I couldn't set it in an out point, but it it had a rewind of about 1 second or 3/4 of a second. And I would wait for something and I'd rewind it and I'd rewind it and I'd get that sound in my head. But then I had to hit pause and I had to go back to my guitar and I had to try and play it. Then I had to take my hands off the guitar, go play again. And I didn't have any slowdown and I didn't have any custom looping. And I still managed to dissect some of the fastest things that Stevie Ray Vaughan ever played using that very primitive fake looping. And so part of the reason I have poured so much energy into developing my courses the way that I do, broken down into individual licks, and part of the reason I've spent so much time programming the instant loops for each of those and programming all these features into the Pro Player is because I remember how tedious that process was. And now, as somebody who has a background as a programmer, I have the ability to make that process so much easier for people who want to study my courses. And in talking to the folks at Vidami, it's obvious they have the same passion. And hardware is like so far out of not only what I'm interested in, but even what I'd be capable of doing. Having a pedal like this that I can spend a few days coding and just have it work with my player, that's like a dream come true, because just the ability to kind of do these operations and not take your hands off of your guitar and do the most essential things, slowing down and controlling the loop. Those are the two building blocks on which learning by ear rests, in my opinion. So, like I said, I'm going to be doing a giveaway. I'm not sure the exact parameters of that, but there's going to be a video announcement coming soon. But I wanted to kind of just give a dedicated video showing off how this awesome pedal works with my player. I do not have the wireless one yet, but I anticipate that'll be exactly the same, except that that one will also work with iPads and everything like that. So that's about it. I think it's a game changer, and for people who are serious, I think it's just going to take your learning up to a completely new level. Thanks for watching.